So Swarup Damodar had the job to check all the whatever people had written, you know, what they came there with. He would hear it first and he would examine it and see if it's all right, make sure there's no mistake, no Mayavadi philosophy.
Swarup Damodar Goswami, his work is to listen to all these works before, and then to check the philosophy of these works is it right, is there any Mayavadi philosophy in here.
Right. So then also, another devotee came to stay in Jagannath Puri with Lord Chaitanya. His name was Govinda.
然后呢，还有另外一位奉献者，他也来到了Jagannath Puri，与Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 住在一起。他的名字呢是 Govinda.
So Swarup Damodar, Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya said, this man Govinda is a Sudra. He's from a Sudra family.
Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 说呢，这位 Govinda 他是来自于一个 Sudra 家庭的。
So Sarvabhauma was surprised that how is it he could be initiated and be the servant of his guru.
所以呢, Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 他就觉得很奇怪，就是他怎么可能被他的 guru 所启迪，并且呢成为他的 guru 的门徒仆人呢？
Who was Govinda's guru?
Govinda 的 guru 是谁呀？
Ishwara Puri.
Ishwara Puri, right. And who's Ishwara Puri's guru?
Ishwara Puri the guru is who?
Govinda Puri.
Huh?
Madhavendra Puri.
Madhavendra Puri, right. Madhavendra Puri, yeah. Okay, so Govinda came to Puri. Why did he leave his guru?
Why
was the guru not satisfied with Govinda's service?
那为什么呢？难道他的guru不满意Govinda对他的服务吗？
Guru很满意，那时候他的guru已经离世了。 Ah, right. His guru was dying. He was leaving the body. So before he left the body, he told Govinda, "You go and serve Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu."
所以说呢，他的guru已经离世了，已经离开了他的躯体。
So, is there any problem with that?
那这有什么问题吗?
First of all, did we?
会有一个问题，因为从传统里面，Vaishnavali里面是一个神兄弟是不能接受其他神兄弟的这样的一个服务的，只能服务他的灵性导师。Okay,
so why did Govinda get to come and serve Lord Chaitanya?
那所以如果这样的话，那为什么Govinda他还来这儿服务 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu呢？
因为门徒的职责是服务他的灵性导师的训示。Yes,
because it's the order of his guru. He has to follow the order of his guru.
那因为这是来自于他的灵性导师的命令，所以呢，他就必须要服从他的灵性导师所给予他的命令。And
why did he get? Why he was from a sudra family? How did he get to be the servant of his guru?
既然是一个Sudra，他怎么得到了去服务他的Guru的，变成就是他的Guru的仆人的这么一个服务呢？
That's because the Guru can choose what he wants. If the Guru wants to initiate someone, if the Guru wants someone to be servant, Guru can decide too. There's no rule or regulation. governing the guru.
因为作为 guru 来讲呢，他可以自行去选择去启迪谁，以及谁可以成为他的贴身仆人。所以呢，作为 guru 选择谁来讲是没有任何硬性的规则的。
Because the guru is representative of Krishna, and Krishna is above rules and regulations.
因为 guru 他所代表的是 Krishna, 而 Krishna 呢，他是超越一切的规范和原则的。
Then another thing which happened when they came back to Jagannath Puri, Lord Chaitanya said he didn't want his servant anymore.
还有另外一件发生的事情，就是当时 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 回到 Jagannath Puri 之后呢，他说他不想再有任何的仆人了。
He wants to get rid of the one servant he took with him. He took the one man, Krishna Das, Kala Krishna Das, he took him with him to South India.But when he came back to Jagannath Puri, he said, I don't want him anymore.
Why
did Lord Chaitanya not want him anymore? Listen.
Yes, Guru Maharaj.
你知道吗？
因为他们遇到了巴塔哈瑞，因为他们遇到了巴塔哈瑞 ，Krishna Das 被巴塔哈瑞给吸引了。
巴塔哈瑞他们是谁？巴塔哈瑞他们是谁？
他们是披着他们虽然穿着 CRC 的外套，但是他们却偷钱、说谎、欺骗。
嗯哼，那他们怎么能吸引？那个 Krishna Das, Kala Krishna Das, 他们能吸引他的 Lord Ju Chaitanya 的仆人，他们用什么？
他把 Krishna Das 吸引到那个帐篷里去，然后在那里，Krishna Das 跟 Badhari 那样的人在一起联谊。
可是他们，那个。
因为他身边有很多。漂亮的女人
啊，
就是
对啊，
被物质上的那个给吸引了。
对，他被女人吸引了，所以他离开 Ju Chaitanya， 所以 Ju Chaitanya 到 Jagannath Puri， he said he didn't want the servant anymore。
所以呢，当 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他回到 Jagannath Puri 的时候呢，他就说他再也不想要仆人了。
所以后发生什么？Ju Chaitanya 的仆人，他可以自杀吗？他应该自杀还是什么？
他应该自杀，但是主
真的吗？应该自杀，那么严格。
不应该自杀，没有灵性导师的命令，他这个躯体也是灵性导师，他没有资格自己选择。
So, 发生什么？
但是主尼塔南达给了他一项特别的服务，让他去找萨奇妈妈，告诉他主柴塔尼亚马哈帕布回来了。
啊，对。所以从这个小月时光，我们知道什么？我们了解什么？
我们了解不能被物质上的这些衣服所吸引，不能被女人所吸引。
还有什么？
我们离不开奉献者的仁慈，尤其在我们犯错误的时候，只有奉献者能够帮助我们，把我们再拉回到 Krishna 的身边。
所以 ，Krishna，we understand the mercy of the devotees is even greater than the mercy of Krishna。
那我们就了解了，作为奉献者所给我们的仁慈，要比 Krishna 所给我们的仁慈要更加的伟大。
Because Lord Chaitanya, he said, I don't want him anymore. He can go and do whatever he wants. I don't want him.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说呢，我不想再要他了，他可以想干嘛就干嘛去吧。
But Lord Nityananda and the other devotees, they gave him shelter and they told him, no, you know, we have service for you. You have to go to Bengal, you have to go to Navadvip, take prasadam, give to Mother Sachi, tell all the devotees, Lord Chaitanya has come.
但是呢，朱尼提亚南达还有其他的奉献者呢，却向 Krishna Das 展示了他们的仁慈，然后对 Krishna Das 说呢，说你应该去到孟加拉，你还有一些这个服务需要做，你需要到孟加拉去把这些 prasadam 带给 Sachin 妈妈，然后呢，告诉所有的这些奉献者们，朱 Chaitanya 妈妈要来了。
And go to Advaita Acharya and Srivas Pandit, tell them to Lord Chaitanya's come, they will want to come here to Jagannath Puri.
然后呢要去告诉Advaita Acharya 还有 Srivas Pandit, 说呢 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 已经回来了，那你们是不是要来 Jagannath Puri 来看望他呢？
So, Kala Krishna Das went to Mayapur to see Mother Sachi.
所以说呢 ，Krishna Das 呢，他就去了 Mayapur 看望Sachi 妈妈。
We can understand also how powerful the material energy is. That even though you're the servant of Lord Chaitanya, Maya can get you.
那我在这里面也明白了，这物质能量是多么的强大。即便是主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的亲身的仆人，依然还是会被 Maya 所迷惑。
Srila Prabhupada used to tell us, "Don't be surprised that somebody falls into Maya."
Srila Prabhupada 曾经就这样告诉我们：当有人跌入 Maya 的陷阱里的时候，可千万别觉得奇怪。
Just be surprised that somebody can stay out of Maya.
如果要是有人他能够始终在 Maya 之外待着的话，这样你才要应该感到奇怪才对。
So Govinda was the servant of Lord Chaitanya, and he pleased all the devotees. He served Lord Chaitanya, and he served all the devotees also.
所以呢 ，Govinda 他就成为了 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的仆人。那这样呢，也很取悦所有的这些奉献者，因为他除了服务 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢，他其实也服务了所有的这些奉献者们。
So he was very much loved by all the devotees.
所以Govinda呢就非常的被所有的这些奉献者们所爱着。
And there was another devotee who was like the godbrother of Govinda and godbrother of Lord Chaitanya. His name was Kashishvara.
还有另外一位奉献者，那他呢是Govinda和 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的神兄弟，他的名字呢是 Kashishvara. Kashishvara.
So his service was.Whenever Lord Chaitanya would go to the Jagannath Puri temple to see Lord Jagannath, he would go in the front and he would clear the way so that Lord Chaitanya could come.
那他的服务呢是每次当 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 到 Jagannath 庙去参拜主 Jagannath 的时候呢，他就会为 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 清道，这样呢就可以让 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu
Because when you go to temple, there's always so many people push and shoving, and so his service was to keep people away from Lord Chaitanya.
Because 每次到庙里的时候呢，总是会有很多人挥来想去的，所以呢，他的服务就是把所有的人都挡在 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的外面，所以呢就不用来打扰 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu。
Yeah, because all the people they see the sannyasi coming, then they all want to touch his feet.
因为所有的人见到一位 sannyasi 进来的时候呢，大家都想去摸他的莲花足。
And you can't walk for people grabbing your feet.
就是因为当有人去抓你的脚的时候，根本连走都走不了了。
So this devotee Kashishvara, his service was to stand and go in front of Lord Chaitanya and keep people back.
所以呢，这位 Kashishvara 奉献者呢，他的服务就是走在 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的前面，然后挡着其他的人。
Okay, so Lord Chaitanya's come back to Jagannath Puri, and different people are coming to meet him and to join and to be with him.
所以 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢就回到了 Jagannath Puri， 然后不同的人呢也都来到这里，和 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 会合来拜见他。
So then a devotee gave a message. He said, Brahmananda Bharati has come to see you, Lord Chaitanya.
然后有一位奉献者就报信说呢， Brahmananda Bharati 来接的吗？是这个吗？
Brahmananda Bharati.
Brahmananda Bharati.
Yeah, yeah. He's come to see Lord Chaitanya.
他来拜见主Chaitanya.
So Brahmananda Bharati, he's from the Mayavadi Sampradaya.
那 Brahmananda Bharati 呢？他是来自于Mayavadi。
Mayavadi, yeah.
他是来自于Mayavadi的。
Means they follow Shankaracharya.
那也就是说呢，他是追随的是Shankaracharya。
Mm-hmm. So they teach everything is one.
那他们的教导呢，就是一切都是一。
Right? When the Mayavadi sannyasis meet, what do they say to each other?
当Mayavadi的sannyasi他们见面之后，他们会对彼此怎么打招呼呢？Charu Chitra，你知道吗？那是什么？你知道吗？Namo Narayana。Namo Narayana.
Yes, Namo Narayana. Namo Narayana. Yes, that's what they say. They say, you know, you're Narayana. You're because you take sannyas means you become God. You become Narayana.
他们的这个打招呼的方式就是由于你接受了sannyasi的启迪，所以呢，你就成为了主Narayana，你就成为了主。
Right, but none of us will be able to take sannyas like that because you have to be born in a Brahmana family to take sannyas.
但是呢，没有任何一个人可以就这么得到sannyasi启迪的，因为如果得到这样的sannyasi启迪呢，必须要出生在一个婆罗门的家里面才有资格。
And of course, we don't want to become Narayana also. We want to become the servant of Krishna. So what's the blessing the devotee gives? Krishne Matir Astu. What does it mean? What's it mean? Shamaista? Yes, very good. Okay. So devotee, we give blessings like that. So devotee said, this Brahmananda Bharati is here. He said, shall I bring him here to meet you? So he said to Lord Chaitanya, he said, can I bring him here to see you? So Lord Chaitanya said, oh, Brahmananda Bharati is like my spiritual master. I should go and see him.
然后，所以Chaitanya Mahaprabhu说呢，Brahmananda Bharati他就好像是我的灵性导师一样，我应该去拜见他。This
is a proper etiquette.
对，这是恰当的礼仪。So
Lord Chaitanya and the devotees they went to see Brahmananda Bharati.
对，那主Chaitanya Mahaprabhu和所有的这些奉献者们呢，就一块去拜见Brahmananda Bharati.
But when Lord Chaitanya went to see him, he saw that he was dressed in a deer skin. So Lord Chaitanya was very unhappy when he saw this. Now, in the scriptures it talks about sometimes that sannyasi that they can wear a deer skin.
但是在经典里面呢，的确讲了，有的时候呢，sannyasi是可以裹着鹿皮的。But
it's very easy to become proud and think you're very renounced because you wear a deer skin.
但是呢，就是由于裹着鹿皮，所以呢，就很容易让人觉得很骄傲，因为他觉得自己非常的气绝。
So if you just wear the deer skin just to impress people, it's not good.
所以呢，只是穿着兔，这个鹿皮而要去， 给别人一个很深刻的印象的话，那这是不好的。
So when Lord Chaitanya saw him like that, Lord Chaitanya pretended that he didn't see him.
所以当时 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 看见他这身打扮的时候呢，他就假装没看见他。
And he said to the devotees, he said, where is Brahmananda Bharati?
所以他就问奉献者 ,Brahmananda Bharati 在哪儿啊？
He's my spiritual master. Where is he?
他是我的灵性导师，他在哪儿啊？
And the devotee said, here he is, Lord Chaitanya, here he is, he's right here in your presence.
然后这位奉献者说，主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, 他都在这儿呢，他就在您的面前。
But Lord Chaitanya said, no, this is not Brahmananda Bharati.
然后主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说，不，这可不是 Brahmananda Bharati.
You must be talking of somebody else. This cannot be Brahmananda Bharati.
你肯定在说别人，因为这位根本就不可能是 Brahmananda Bharati。
Why would Brahmananda Bharati wear a deer skin?
Bharati 会穿会裹着鹿皮呢。
You don't have any knowledge.
哎，你真的什么也不知道。
So when Brahmananda Bharati heard this, he thought, oh.Lord Chaitanya does not like me to have to wear the deer skin.
So, when Brahmananda Bharati 听到了主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的这一席话之后呢，他就在想，哦，主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他不喜欢我穿着鹿皮的样子。
So Brahmananda Bharati realized that he'd made a mistake by coming there wearing a deer skin.
So, when Brahmananda Bharati 他就意识到了，他穿着鹿皮来到这里。
And he thought about, Brahmananda Bharati thought about everything in his mind, and he understood. He said, actually, it's true. I'm only wearing this deer skin for my good name, to get a big name.
Brahmananda Bharati 在内心里面就回想了一遍，他就在想，的确是这样的。我穿着这鹿皮，其实就是为了要打造我自己的名声。
But I should, I'm so foolish. I should know that wearing a deer skin will not help me to get out of material illusion.
但是呢，我却如此的愚蠢。我应该知道，实际上穿着这鹿皮，对于我走出这物质的虚幻是没有任何帮助的。
So Brahmananda Bharati decided.From today on, I will not wear this deer skin anymore. So Lord Chaitanya could understand his mind, and Lord Chaitanya immediately sent some robe, some cloth of the sannyasi for him.
所以主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢是明白他的内心所想的，所以呢他就立刻。给他送来了一些sannyasi的这个袍服。
Because Lord Chaitanya is a sannyasi, so people often give sannyasis cloth. So you have a lot of cloth, you know, you get so much cloth, and Lord Chaitanya doesn't mind to give a set of cloth away to Brahmananda Bharati.
因为 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他自己本人是 sannyasi, 所以呢，经常就会有人送给他 sannyasi 所穿的这种袍服，所以还有很多。所以呢，他自己不介意送一身给 Brahmananda Bharati。
And when Brahmananda Bharati put on the sannyasi robes, then Lord Chaitanya came and offered him obeisances.
那么，当 Brahmananda Bharati 穿上了 sannyasi 的袍服之后呢 ，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 再次来到他的面前，并且顶拜了他。
So Lord Chaitanya, Brahmananda Bharati thanked Lord Chaitanya. He said that you have taught me.By your behavior, you have taught me the proper behavior.
然后 Brahmananda Bharati 呢就感谢了 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu， 说呢，你是以你非常恰当的举止教导了我。
I will try not to do anything you don't like.
我呢将努力做，我将努力的不去做任何你不喜欢做的，你不喜欢的事情。
Because if I do something which you don't like.Then you will neglect me, you will just ignore me, and this will be very bad for me, very painful for me.
因为如果我要是做了错事的话呢，那你就会不理我，那这对我来说是非常的痛苦的。
So then, Brahmananda Bharati begins to speak some philosophy with Lord Chaitanya.
然后呢 ，Brahmananda Bharati 呢就开始向 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 讲述一些哲学。
Because he's a Mayavadi sannyasi, so he has some Mayavadi leaning to the philosophy.
那因为呢，他是一位 Mayavadi sannyasi， 所以呢，他对于就他有一些这个关于 Mayavadi 的哲学理念。
Mayavadis, they like to see everything one, or if there's only the oneness of Brahman. Everyone is Brahman.
Because Mayavadi, his philosophy 理念呢是一的概念，所以呢，他认为所有的一切都是 Brahman， 都是凡。
So he says to Lord Chaitanya, he said, "I can see two Brahmans. I see one Brahman is Lord Jagannath, and the other Brahman is you."
然后Brahmananda Bharati 他就说呢，他说我可以看到两个 Brahman， 一个呢是主 Jagannath， 另外一个 Brahman 呢是您。
So Lord Jagannath, he's a deity, so he cannot move. He's not moving. But you're moving. But you're both Brahman.
主 Jagannath 他是一尊神像，所以呢他是不能移动的。可是您呢是可以移动的。但是你们俩呢，都是 Brahman。
So both Lord Jagannath and Lord Chaitanya, you're both the same. You're both Brahman, but Lord Jagannath is not moving, but you're moving.
对的，主 Jagannath 还有您主 Chaitanya， 你们都是 Brahman， 你们是同样的，是没有区别的。但是呢，主 Jagannath 是不能移动的，而您是可以移动的。
Lord Jagannath is blackish color, but you're very fair complexion. Otherwise, you're both the same.
主 Jagannath 呢所具备的是黑色的皮肤的颜色，而您呢是白皙的肤色，这是你们俩唯一的区别。否则的话呢，你们俩没有区别，是一样的。
You are both delivering the whole world. You're delivering the people.
你们俩呢都在拯救整个世界，都在拯救大众。
But Lord Chaitanya says to him, he said, actually, he said, because of your presence, there are two Brahmans at Jagannath Puri.
但是 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 对他说呢，就是由于你的出现，使得 Jagannath Puri 有了两个 Brahman。
We have Brahmananda Bharati, he's a Mayavadi sannyasi, and we have Lord Chaitanya, and they're both moving. They're both Brahman, and they're both moving.
那我们呢有 Brahmananda Bharati, 他是一位 Mayavadi 的 sannyasi, 那然后我们还有主 Chaitanya, 那他们俩呢都是移动的，是移动的 Brahman.
And you have Lord Jagannath,Lord Jagannath is the Supreme Brahman, he's also, but he's not moving, he's sitting.
然后呢还有主 Jagannath. 主 Jagannath 他是至尊的 Brahman, 但是呢他是就是稳坐在那里的，他不动。
So Brahmananda Bharati, he was trying to say there's no difference between God and the living entity, the Jiva.
Brahmananda Bharati 他想阐述的观点呢，就是在主以及与生物体，就是与这个个体灵魂 Jiva 之间是没有任何区别的。
It's all one, all Brahman.
都是一，都是 Brahman.
Krishna is Brahman. We are also Brahman. Everything is Brahman.
Krishna 是 Brahman， 我们也是 Brahman， 一切都是 Brahman。
So he was saying like that, it's all, there's no difference. But Lord Chaitanya, he said, Lord Chaitanya and Brahmananda Bharati, they are jivas, they are very small. And Krishna, who's Brahman, he's very great. Krishna, Jagannath is the Supreme Brahman, he's very great, But Lord Chaitanya said, me and Brahmananda Bharati, we're very small, we're jivas. So there are many jivas, but there's only one Supreme Lord.
那有很多的jiva，可是只有一位至尊主。But
another understanding can also be given to what Brahmananda Bharati is saying.
但是呢，对于Brahmananda Bharati他所讲述的话呢，还有另外一种理解方式。That
he wants to show that Lord Chaitanya and Jagannath are both the Supreme Personality of Godhead. They're one, no difference.
因为他想说的呢，是主Chaitanya Mahaprabhu与主Jagannath，他们都是至尊人格守神，他们是一样的，没有任何区别。But
Jagannath appears to be staying in one place, and Lord Chaitanya is moving everywhere.
但是呢，主Jagannath呢，他只是在一个地方显现，可是主Chaitanya Mahaprabhu呢，他会去到任何地方。
So this way, Lord Chaitanya and Brahmananda Bharati were arguing, who's right? So Brahmananda Bharati, he asked Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya that you come and decide who's right. I'm having an argument with Lord Chaitanya. You can come and decide. Tell me who's right. Brahmananda is saying, the jiva is very small, he's just in one place.
Brahmananda said that.
Yes, yes.
Brahmananda Bharati said, the jiva is very small, it's just in one place.
But the Supreme Lord, the Brahman, Supreme Brahman, the Paramatma, is everywhere.
但是呢，至尊的Brahman，Paramatma，超灵呢，它是无处不在的。
13th chapter of Bhagavad Gita describes how Krishna is everywhere by the Brahman.
那么在《国家梵歌》的第13章里面，Krishna他就描述了通过Brahman使得Krishna如何的无处不在。
Shetrajam Chapimam Vidhi Sarva Shetreshu Bharata. Like that, Krishna said, I am the knower in all bodies. So, Krishna's in the form, by the Brahman, he's distributed everywhere.
那所以说呢，Krishna他就以这个Brahman的形式被派到了所有的地方。
But there's also the form of the Lord, which is in one place.
但是呢，主他有一个形象，他这个形象呢，就只会留在一个地方。
So Lord Chaitanya, he's arguing with the Brahmananda like this about who's right.
那么所以刚才呢是Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu的辩词，他就在和Brahmananda Bharati在这样辩论着。
So Brahmananda Bharati says that Lord Chaitanya purified me by taking away my deer skin.
那Brahmananda Bharati说呢，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu通过拿走了我的鹿皮而净化了我。
Actually, Lord Chaitanya didn't take away the deer skin, but by the arrangement of Krishna, it happened that he could understand that the deer skin is wrong.
事实上呢，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu并没有拿走他的鹿皮，不过呢，就是在Sri Krishna的安排之下，使得Brahmananda Bharati 意识到了这个带鹿皮这件事是不对的。Anyway,
Brahmananda Bharati said, Lord Chaitanya got me to take off my deer skin, so he's very powerful, and I'm under his control.
那无论如何呢，Brahmananda Bharati说呢，是Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu促使我脱掉了我的鹿皮，所以说呢。 他是非常的具有力量的，那我呢就要臣服于他，为他做，我是他的仆人。
So it's a friendly discussion, but they're just trying to discuss on the basis of philosophy.
他们两人之间这个辩论呢是很友好的辩论，但是他们是就是在这个哲学的基础上进行个辩论。
So then the Brahmananda quotes this famous verse from the Mahabharata about Lord Chaitanya actually.
然后呢，是这个 Brahmananda Bharati 呢，就引述了在 Mahabharata 中的一个很著名的描述关于 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的事件。
And this verse describes all the activities of Lord Chaitanya.
在这个世界里面呢，就描述了 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的所有的活动。
That his body is very golden color.
并且描述了他的这个身体的肤色呢是金色的。
That his body has sandalwood pulp over it.
而且他的身体上呢也是被檀香浆液所遮盖。
That he's always chanting the holy name of the Lord.
并且呢他总是在唱诵着主的圣名。
And that he's very peaceful.
而且他很平和。
And later in life, he will renounce family life. In early life, he'll be a householder, but later in life, he will renounce.
然后当他在是一个家庭居士的时候呢，他是一个居家的居士。那么后来的时候呢，他会过上弃绝的生活。
Yeah. So, this verse is from the Vishnu Sahasranam, describing Lord Chaitanya.
那么这个事件呢是来自于 Vishnu Sahasrana 这一部分的，是由 Sri Krishna, sorry, is the said by Sri Krishna, is what I'm saying?
Vishnu Sahasrana.
这个是来自于 Vishnu Sahasrana 的。
So Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya says to Lord Chaitanya, he said, I think Brahmananda Bharati is the winner. I think his what he says is right.
然后呢 Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 对 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说呢，说我觉得呢 Brahmananda Bharati 他是圣者，因为他说的是对的。
So Lord Chaitanya said, yeah, I agree. Whatever he says is right. It's all right with me. Because he's my guru. So the duty of the disciple is to be defeated by the guru.
然后 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说呢，的确他说的是对的。他说的什么我都接受，因为他是我的灵性导师。那么作为一个门徒，他所要履行的职责就是被他的姑姑所击败。
Disciple's not supposed to argue with the guru.
这样的门徒本来就不应该跟姑姑辩论。
Just like sometimes Prabhupada would be giving class, and then. And if somebody was sitting listening to class with their eyes closed, Prabhupada would say, "You're sleeping."
那就好像有的时候呢，当舍帕帕在讲课的时候，当时在听课的这个奉献者是把眼睛给闭着的，然后舍帕帕就会说，你睡着了。
Devotee would say, "No, Prabhupada, I'm not sleeping."
然后这个奉献者呢，一个就会很警醒的说，没有，舍帕帕，我没睡觉。
Prabhupada would say, I saw you, your eyes were closed, you were sleeping.
然后舍帕帕说呢，我看见了，你的眼睛是闭着的，你刚才就是在睡觉。
And the devotee would say, Prabhupada, my eyes were closed, but I was not sleeping.
然后奉献者说，舍帕帕呢，我眼睛是闭着的，但是我没睡。
And Prabhupada would say, if your eyes are closed and you're not moving, you must be asleep.
然后舍帕帕说，既然你的眼睛是闭着的，而且呢，你也没有动，你肯定是在睡觉。
So, shouldn't argue with the spiritual master.
所以说呢，不要和灵性导师辩论。
And so Lord Chaitanya is saying like that. He said, "Brahmananda Bharati, he's my guru. I should be defeated by him. He's right. I'm wrong."
对呢，是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说呢 ，Brahmananda Bharati 他是我的灵性导师，所以说呢，他说的肯定是对的，我错了。
So sometimes. when if you ever have a disagreement with your guru, you have to accept that they're right.
对，有的时候呢，当你有和自己的灵性导师不同意见的时候呢，你一定要接受灵性导师说的是对的。
Just like sometimes in family life, husband and wife may have a quarrel.
那比如说呢，就在这家庭生活中，有的时候丈夫和妻子之间可能会吵架。
So I've heard some men say, the important thing in family life is to know that your wife is always right.
那我听到有的这个男士跟我说呢，就是在家里面有一个非常重要的原则，就是你永远都接受你妻子说的是对的。
If you remember that your wife is always right, then you have a peaceful family life.
如果你要是能够记得你的妻子永远都是对的的话，那你肯定就会有一个非常平静祥和的家庭生活。
But if you try to argue with your wife, you can have a lot of trouble.
但是如果你要是老是想和你的妻子进行辩论的话，那你这生活里面肯定就会遇到很多很多的麻烦。
Okay, so Brahmananda, however, when he hears Lord Chaitanya say that, he said, there's another reason for your defeat. He said, it's not that I'm, because you're my disciple and I'm your guru. He said, there's another reason why I have defeated you.
Brahmananda Bharati 听的 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 这么一说呢，他说其实你为什么被击败还有另外一个原因，并不是由于我是你的灵性导师，你是我的我是你的灵性导师，你是我的门徒。
And he said, it's the nature of the Lord to accept defeat at the hands of his devotee.
他说呢，作为主，他的本性就是他会接受他在他的门徒在他的这个奉献者手上所得到的失败。
This is sometimes we see this in the pastimes of the Lord Krishna, that he likes to be defeated by his devotees.
那这个我们有的时候呢会在主 Krishna 的逍遥时光中能看到，因为 Krishna 他很喜欢被他的奉献者所击败，输在他的奉献者的手上。
And the example of this taking place is that when Arjuna was fighting with grandfather Bhishma.
那关于这个的例子呢，是当Arjuna 和他的祖父 Bhishma 进行打斗的时候。
So Arjuna's chariot got stuck. And the wheel got stuck. The wheel came off the chariot and there was some problem there. Arjuna was in danger.
那么当时 Arjuna 所驾的这辆战车呢出了问题，他的这个轮子被卡在那儿了，所以呢使得 Arjuna 他就处在一个很危险的境地。
So Bhishma was coming. He was coming in to kill Arjuna.
那所以这会儿呢 Bhishma 就来到 Arjuna 面前要杀死 Arjuna。
But Krishna picked up the chariot wheel and he came running towards Bhishma.
但是呢 Krishna 他这会儿就抄起了从战车上掉下来的这个轮子，并且抄起这个轮子就奔向了 Bhishma.
Because Krishna had promised that he would protect his devotee.
因为 Krishna 他承诺了他要保护他的奉献者。
But he'd also promised he wouldn't fight.
但是 Krishna 他也承诺了他不参战。
But when he saw Arjuna's life in danger, he broke his promise.
但是呢，当他看到 Arjuna 的生命受到危险的时候，他打破了他自己的誓言。
So Bhishma had promised. He said, "Tomorrow, either I will kill Arjuna or Krishna will break his promise."
那然后呢？这个 Bhishma 他就说呢，他说要不然就是我会杀死 Arjuna。或者呢 ，Krishna 他就会打破他的誓言。
So Krishna broke his promise rather than let Arjuna be killed.
那所以呢 ，Krishna 他没有让 Arjuna 被 Bhishma 杀死，而是自己打破了誓言。
So this was a very important pastime.
那这是一个很重要的逍遥时光。
So Krishna doesn't show his devotee Krishna likes to protect his devotee.
所以说呢 ，Krishna 他是喜欢保护他的奉献者的。
And he will break his own promise to protect his devotee.
他为了保护他的奉献者，他会打破他自己的誓言。
So Brahmananda Bharati said that since the beginning of his life, I've been attached to the impersonal Brahman.
那Brahmananda Bharati 说呢，就从他一出生，他就开始对非人格的 Brahman 非常的依附。
Yeah, he's a Mayavadi sannyasi, so he said, "All he said, my whole life I've been attached to the impersonal Brahman."
他说呢，因为他是一位 Mayavadi sannyasi, 所以呢，他整个的一生都对于非人格的 Brahman 非常的依附。
But somehow, since I've seen you, Lord Chaitanya, I've become attached to Krishna.
但是，不知怎的，自从我见到了您Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的时候呢，我就开始变得对 Krishna 依附起来。
So Brahmananda Bharati became a devotee of Krishna by the mercy of Lord Chaitanya.
所以呢 ，Brahmananda Bharati 在 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的仁慈之下，成为了 Sri Krishna 的奉献者。
And he said to Lord Chaitanya, he said, since I see you, I feel Lord Krishna's presence.
然后 Brahmananda Bharati 对 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说呢，自从我见到您之后，我就一直能够感受到 Sri Krishna 的临在。
I now even want to chant the name of Krishna.
而现在呢，我总是想要唱诵 Krishna 的名字。
And Brahmananda says to Lord Chaitanya, I think you are Krishna and I want to be your servant.
然后 Brahmananda Bharati 又对 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说呢，说我觉得您就是 Krishna, 我希望能够成为您的仆人。
And Brahmananda says, my condition is like that of a Mayavadi. I'm a Mayavadi. He said,I'm the same as other Mayavadis. I'm attached to the impersonal Brahman.
然后 Brahmananda Bharati 说呢，说我的这个受条件限制的状态就是我是一位 Mayavadi。那我和其他的 Mayavadi 呢也都是一样的，我对于非人格的凡非常的依附。
But I can give it up for Krishna, for realization of the personal feature of God.
但是呢。我可以为了 Krishna, 为了能够意识到就是觉悟到至尊人格首神的人格特征而放弃对非人格的梵的依附。
In the beginning of my life, I was a monist, thinking everything is one.
那在我的生命之初呢，我是一个一元论者，我认为所有的一切都是一。
And then I got realization, I got initiated into the yoga system.
但然后呢，我就得到了觉悟，我就被启迪在了这瑜伽体系之中。
But now I've been tricked by that boy, cunning boy, who's always joking with the gopis.
但是呢，我现在被那个总是和 gopi 们一起开玩笑的那个男孩所戏弄了。
Lord Chaitanya told Brahmananda Bharati, he said, you have a deep love for Krishna. So wherever you put your eyes, wherever you look, you will see Krishna. Because you have Krishna consciousness, so...You, wherever you look, you see Krishna. So Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya is listening to all this and he said, yeah, I think you're both right. Krishna lets us see him through his mercy.
那然后 Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 说呢，你们俩说的都是对的。那么 Krishna 呢是通过他的仁慈让我们能够看到他。
I said, without having love for Krishna, you cannot see him.
他说呢，如果要是没有对 Krishna 的爱的话，是没有办法见到 Krishna 的。
So through the mercy of Lord Chaitanya, Brahmananda Bharati can now see Krishna.
所以在 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的仁慈之下，现在呢 Brahmananda Bharati 他就能够见到 Krishna 了。
Yeah, it's the mercy of Lord Chaitanya.
对呢，这是来自于 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的仁慈。
So when Lord Chaitanya heard this, he said, oh no, no, don't say like this. And Lord Chaitanya chants, Vishnu, save me. Lord Chaitanya doesn't want to get...too much glorification. He doesn't want people to speak about him like he's God. So when he heard people praise him, then Lord Chaitanya called out to Vishnu, Vishnu, save me.
当 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 听到别人在赞扬他的时候呢，他就大声地呼唤着 Vishnu, Vishnu, 请来救我。
So Lord Chaitanya then took Brahmananda Bharati to his home, and Brahmananda Bharati would often stay with Lord Chaitanya.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢就把 Brahmananda Bharati 给请回了自己的家里，然后呢 Brahmananda Bharati 呢就和 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 住在一起。
So this way many devotees all came and stayed with Lord Chaitanya. They took shelter at his lotus feet. And Lord Chaitanya would give everybody mercy, and he would always...come to meet different devotees, give shelter, and show them mercy, give them, protect them. Only one person didn't get mercy, that was the king.
但是呢，只有一个人没有得到仁慈，这个人呢就是国王。
Maharaj Prataparudra, the name of the king of Puri, the Maharaj of Puri, Maharaj, he's a very nice devotee, but Lord Chaitanya doesn't want to meet him.
是 Prataparudra 王，那么这是在 Puri 的国王，那么他是一位非常好的奉献者。可是呢，水车丹娘马法布呢却不同意见他。
So one day, Sarvabhauma told Lord Chaitanya, "I want to ask permission. I want you to give permission for something. Please allow me to ask."
然后有一天呢 ，Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 就对水车丹娘马法布说呢，有一件事呢，我得得到您的允许。您得允许我向您提出这个请求。
So Lord Chaitanya said, "Well."You can ask, but I may not accept it, and I may not like it, I may reject it.
然后 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说呢，你可以提，但是呢，我也许可能不喜欢你所提出来的这个请求，所以说呢，我也许可能会拒绝你。
So the Bhattacharya tells Lord Chaitanya, there's a king here, he wants to meet you, and he wants your permission, he wants you to agree to meet him.
然后呢 ，Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 对 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说呢，这里有一个人，就是我们的国王，他希望能够得到您的允许，被您接见，他想见您。
But as soon as Lord Chaitanya heard king, then he covered his ears and said, "Oh no, why are you asking such a thing from me?"
然后 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 一听到国王这个词的时候呢。他立刻就堵住自己的耳朵，然后呢就说，你为什么要让我给你这样的一个仁慈呢？
He said, "I'm in the renounced order. It's very dangerous for me to meet a king."
那我呢是在气绝阶层的，对于我来说，去见一位国王是非常危险的事情。
To meet a king or to meet a woman who has material desires is like drinking poison.
去见有物质欲望的国王或者是女子，那就都像喝毒药一样。
So, Lord Chaitanya told Bhattacharya that it's against the scriptures for sannyasi to meet materialistic people.
被水切丹尼万法布对萨尔巴巴巴的查尔说，作为一个 sannyasi 去见有物质欲望的人来说呢，是打破这个条规的。
Sannyasi wants to get out of the material world, but very difficult to get out of the material world if he associates with materialistic people.
那 Sannyasi 呢，他是希望能够让自己出离这物质世界，但是如果要是和有物质倾向的人去联谊的话，那他要离开，就是要让自己弃绝这个世界，就会变得很难。
Of course, ordinary people in the material world, they don't know anything about spiritual life. They have no spiritual education.
那么当然呢，作为一个在物质世界生活的普通人来说呢，他们是不知道任何的关于灵性生活的这个信息的，因为他们没有任何的关于灵性的教育。
But spiritual life means to stop material activities.
但是灵性的生活也就意味着要停止这些物质的活动。
And to take up spiritual activities. Spiritual activities mean bhakti yoga, doing things for Krishna.
然后呢，要开始进行灵性的活动。那么灵性的活动呢，也就意味着是要进行 bhakti yoga 的活动，也就意味着是要为 Krishna 做服务的活动。
But Lord Chaitanya knows that this, the king,He's always busy in politics and economic things. He has to take care of so many economic affairs and politics. That's his whole life.
但是呢，作为一个国王，他在整个一生中呢，他都必须要去照管着很多的和物质相关的这些事宜。
So although Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya is very nice devotee, an intimate friend of Lord Chaitanya. Lord Chaitanya refused to meet the king.
那虽然说萨罗巴玛巴达查尔他是水切丹尼玛法布的一位好朋友，但是呢，水切丹尼玛法布依然还是拒绝了这位国王，拒绝了去见国王。
But Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, he tells Lord Chaitanya, he said, "Yeah, I know what you're saying is true, but this king." Is not an ordinary king.
然后萨尔巴纳巴达查尔说呢，我知道您说的这个事情呢是对的，也确实是这么回事儿。但是呢，这位国王他并不是一位普通的国王。
That he's a this king is a great devotee and he's a servant of Lord Jagannath.
这位国王他是一位非常伟大的奉献者，他是主 Jagannath 的仆人。
So you know that's a very humble position for the king to take to become the servant of Lord Jagannath.
而且呢，这对于国王来说呢，他就是非常的低调，他非常谦卑的让自己愿意屈就成为一个仆人。
But Lord Chaitanya argues, he said, "Well, okay, he's a great devotee, but still, he's like a poison snake."
然后这陈太太妈妈不就说呢？好吧，没问题，他可能是一位很伟大的奉献者，好的奉献者，但是那他依然还是像蛇的毒药一样。
And Lord Chaitanya gives the example. He said, just like you may have the form of a woman made out of wood, you know, you have these things which they put in the shop window. You have the form of a woman made out of some wood or plastic or something.And they dress them. So one may have a wood, the form of the woman made out of wood. And if one touches it, one can become agitated. The man can be agitated simply by touching the wooden form.
那他说呢，也许可能就是有一个木头雕的女子的形象。那么有的时候在商店里面，我们会看到由木头啊，或者由塑料所构成的这个 模特的这个样子，然后呢在这个模特的身上再给他穿上衣服。那么那释迦牟尼佛说呢，就是虽然说这个女人的这个形象它是由木头所雕成的，但是呢当一碰了这个形象之后呢，就会使男人的这个内心中产生焦灼感。
So when Lord Chaitanya said he's like a poison snake, it means just like if you have a snake with some jewel on its head. You know, some snakes, there are special snakes, they have jewels on their head. But still they're poisonous and they're very dangerous.
那释迦丹念妈妈不说呢，就像这个蛇的毒液一样。那当然有些蛇呢，它在头上会带着珠冠，那一些很特别的蛇，它是会有这样的珠冠在头的。但是它即便是它带着这个很漂亮的珠冠，但它依然是有毒的蛇。
So I have to be very careful in dealing with materialistic people.
所以说呢，当在和物质主义者进行打交道的时候，我们一定要非常的小心。
Just like when you deal with a snake, with has a jewel in its head, you have to be very careful.
那就好像是当你在和一个头戴着珠冠的蛇在打交道的时候，你一定要非常的小心。
So we have to control the mind. The mind is very important. You have to make sure the mind is trained to give up sense gratification.
那所以说呢，我们就一定要非常小心的去训练我们的心意，因为心意它实际上是占据着一个很重要的位置的，但是呢，我们一定要好好的要训练这个心意，让心意放弃掉这些和物质相关的事情。
If the senses and the mind are not properly engaged, then they will become the enemy of the soul.
那当感官和心意在没有很好的、恰当的去从事活动的时候，那么这个感官和心意都有可能成为灵魂的敌人。
So Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, by his example, was very careful about dealing with materialistic people.
对，所以 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢，就身体力行的，告诉我们如何要非常小心的去应对那些物质主义者。
So we see many examples in the scriptures about people who.Got into difficulty trying to become self-realized.
那我们在这个释迦牟尼佛里面也听到了好多，就是当一个人他在想得到自我觉悟的这个过程中，实际上是要遇到很多的艰难的，遇到很多的问题，很多麻烦。
So, one who's a sannyasi, shouldn't even look at the bodily features of a woman.
所以说呢，一位sannyasi他甚至于不要去看，处在女子身形中的这个形象。
And then Lord Chaitanya said to the Bhattacharya, "If you keep speaking like this, I'm going to leave here. You'll never see me again."
然后Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 对 Bhattacharya 说，如果你要是再继续这么说的话，那我就再也不理你了，我再也不想跟你说话了。
So, I'm just telling you, be careful.
对呢，我只是告诉你一定要小心。
So, Sarvabhauma became afraid when Lord Chaitanya spoke like that. He became afraid and he began to meditate and went home.
然后呢，当释迦丹尼玛哈布这么一说话以后呢 ，Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 他就很害怕了，而且呢，他就开始在冥想释迦丹尼玛哈布说这话，然后就回家去了。
So then the king of Puri comes to Jagannath Puri. The king of Puri, he has his palace in the capital at Cuttack. So he came from Cuttack, the town up some distance away. He came to the Jagannath Puri temple. He comes to see the deities and to see the devotees.
那 Puri 的这个国王呢，他就因为他的宫邸呢是在首都 Cuttack， 然后呢他就来到了 Jagannath Puri。 并且呢到 Javanapuri 来参拜神像以及来拜见所有的这些奉献者们探望这些奉献者们。
So he comes, when the king comes, he has many people with him. He has his secretaries and his ministers and officers. They all come to see the deity.
当国王来的时候呢，他身边跟了很多的随行人员，他的大臣呐，他的仆人呐，全部都和他一起到庙里面参拜神像。
So the king came with.He also came, Ramananda Rai also came with him.
但当国王来的时候呢 ，Ramananda Rai 也是一起随行而来的。
So Ramananda Rai comes to Puri. He immediately goes to meet Lord Chaitanya.
那么当 Ramananda Rai 他来到 Puri 之后呢，他立刻就去拜见 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
And they embrace each other and they begin to cry.
他们彼此相互拥抱在了一起，并且开始哭泣了起来。
Who is Ramananda Rai in Krishna Lila?
在 Krishna Lila 中 ，Ramananda Rai 是谁呀
？Vishakha.
And who is Swarup Damodar?
Lalita.
Okay. Right. And then, who is Lord Chaitanya, Krishna Lila?
在 Krishna Lila 里面，是
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 是
谁呀？
Radha Rani.
Krishna
and Radha.
Krishna and Radha, right? Combined form. Radha Krishna Nayan, right? The combined.
是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 是 Radha 和 Krishna 的合并体。
So.When all the devotees saw Lord Chaitanya, very intimate with Ramananda Rai, all devotees were very surprised. They didn't know Lord Chaitanya knew Ramananda Rai.
When 当奉献者看到 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 和 Ramananda Rai 如此亲密的这种互动的时候呢，他们都感到非常的惊讶，因为他们并不知道 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 认识 Ramananda Rai.
Because Lord Chaitanya had gone.There, at that time, he only had one devotee. He only had the Kala Krishna Das with him, so they didn't know.
So, because when Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, met Ramananda Rai, he was only with Krishna Das, one servant, so other devotees didn't know this.
So Ramananda Rai tells Lord Chaitanya, "I told the king about your order that you want me to give up service," and the king was very happy. He said, "Yes."Retire.
所以呢 ，Ramananda Rai 说呢，我跟国王说了，说您想让我放弃我现在在政府里面的这个服务的工作，然后国王呢就非常的开心，说好吧，那你就退休吧。
Ramananda Rai said, "I don't want to do any more politics for you. I only want to stay with Lord Chaitanya. So please give me permission."
然后 Ramananda Rai 对国王说呢，我现在呢不想再为你从事任何的政治方面的这个服务了，我现在唯一想做的事情呢就是和 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 在一起，所以请您允许我。
And when the king heard this, he was very pleased, and he got up from his throne, and he came and embraced Ramananda Rai.
所以当国王听 Ramananda Rai 这么一说呢，他就非常的欣慰开心，他就从他的王座上站起来。并且呢，拥抱了 Ramananda Rai。
Ramananda Rai is telling Lord Chaitanya. He said, "When I told the king your name, the king became ecstatic."
然后 Ramananda Rai 对 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说，当我把您的名字报给国王的时候，国王他立刻就变得极乐了起来。
And he took me by the hand and.He was so happy. He was so pleased to hear your name.
然后他一下抓住了我的手，他可开心了。他听见你的名字可开心了。
And he's giving me a pension. He said, and he doesn't want me to work. And he's giving me a pension, a full pension.
而且呢，他还给了我一个很好的一笔退休金。他不想让我再工作了。 给了我的退休金。
He doesn't want me to have any anxiety as your servant.
那么他呢，他不想让我在服务你的时候呢有任何的焦虑。
And Maharaj and Ramananda Roy is telling Lord Chaitanya, he said, the king said, I am very fallen, I'm very terrible, I'm not fit to get an interview, I'm not fit to meet Lord Chaitanya.
然后 Ramananda Roy 对 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说呢，说国王说我非常的堕落，然后呢，我一点儿也不配见到 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu， Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 也不想见我。
My life is only successful if I can engage in his service.
但是如果我要是能够致力于对他的服务的话，我的生命才能够变得成功。
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Krishna, the son of Nanda Maharaj.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 是 Krishna, 他是 Nanda Maharaj 的爱儿。
I can only hope that in a future birth,He will be merciful to me and allow me to meet him.
In a future birth. Oh, okay. 那我唯一的希望就是在将来的某一个生世，我能够得到对他的接见。
Ramananda Rai tells Lord Chaitanya, he said, I think the king has much more love than I have.
然后 Ramananda Roy 对 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说呢，我觉得这位国王对您的爱要比我对您的爱要深多了。
I think he's a better devotee than me.
那我觉得他是一个比我更好的贡献者。
But Lord Chaitanya said, Oh, Ramananda Roy, you are the best devotee of Krishna.
但是 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说 Oh, Ramananda Roy, 但是你是 Sri Krishna 最好的。
And whoever loves you, he is also a very fortunate person.
那任何一个爱你的人呢，他也是一个非常幸运的人。
And because the king has shown so much, he's shown so much love for you, so Krishna will certainly be kind to him.
由于他呢向你展示了这么多爱，那毫无疑问 ，Krishna 也会对他仁慈的。
So Ramananda Rai is describing the good qualities of the king. And how the king is so eager to meet Lord Chaitanya. And because the king loves Ramananda, the king loves, but still he gave him a pension and he allowed him to retire.So he could be with Lord Chaitanya.
This 国王呢，他很爱 Ramananda， 但是呢，他依然，为了要让 Ramananda 能够服务 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu， 他给了他一笔退休金。
So Lord Chaitanya said, Krishna will certainly accept him because of his love, because of his kindness to you. Krishna will be kind to him.
那Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu说呢，就是由于他对你的爱，他对你的这份慈悲 ，Krishna 毫无疑问是会接受他的。
Of course, this is also stated in the scriptures like that.
那么当然呢，就是在经典里面也是这样去描述的。
Krishna says, "Those who are my devotee, they're not really my devotee."
Krishna 说。那些声称是我的奉献者的人，他并不是我的真正的奉献者。
But those who are the devotee of my servants, they are my devotees.
但是那些宣称是我的仆人的奉献者，他们才是我的奉献者。
So service to the devotees is very, very important.
所以说呢，服务奉献者是非常非常重要的。
Okay, are there any questions here today?
Yes. Here is a question from Subhuti Raya Prabhu. 顶拜 Guru Maharaj 莲花族，顶拜翻译和奉献者，请问主 Chaitanya 不想见国王，即便他是一个奉献者，而 Srila Prabhupada 教导经常教导 Yukta Varagya 真正的气绝，把一切用于服务 Krishna， 他主动去见一些社会上的重要人物。如何理解两种看似不同的榜样呢？是主柴坦尼亚想树立更严格的榜样吗？或是舍拉帕帕为了传教而做出了调整？Guru Maharaj, please accept my very humble obeisances to your lotus feet, and also my humble obeisances to translator and the devotees. My question is that Lord Chaitanya doesn't want to meet this king. However, even the king is a devotee. However, Srila Prabhupada, for the reason of preaching, and he also teaching us the Yukta Vairagya, the real renunciation, render everything to serve to the Lord. So he will proactively to meet some dignitaries, very important people in the society. So how to understand these two different examples? One is Lord Chaitanya doesn't want to meet a king, but the other is Srila Prabhupada, for the preaching, he want to proactively to meet those kind of VIPs. Is that Lord Chaitanya want to establish a more strict examples, or Srila Prabhupada, for the reason of preaching, has done some adjustment?
Yes, Lord Chaitanya was showing the example of a sannyasi 500 years ago. And remember, Lord Chaitanya had taken sannyas in the line of Shankaracharya. And they're very conservative. They have a lot of rules about who they can meet and who can come near to them. So at least in the time of Lord Chaitanya, it was certainly like that in India.
那至少在印度，在 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的年代的时候呢，是这样的。
A sannyasi would not meet a materialistic person like the king.
所以呢，三亚西他是不会去见像国王这样的物质倾向的人的。
And a woman could not come near sannyasi.
而且作为女子来说呢，也是不能够接近三亚西的。
Even today, they have the rules that, you know, a woman want to come in the same room where a sannyasi, a Mayavadi sannyasi is, they have to dress in a full sari. The full-length sari means the sari will cover their body very carefully. And
they, 那便是在今天，如果是一位女子她进入到一位 Mayavadi sannyasi 的房间的话，那她一定要用 sari 把自己的身体要包得严严实实的。
And the hair has to be tied up.
而且头发呢一定要绑起来，一定要梳起来。
Put the sari over the top of the head.
然后 sari 呢一定要盖住头发。
So this is the custom. This is the culture, and it was very much present 500 years ago in the time of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
那所以呢，这个就是三亚寺要遵循的习俗，当时的文化。而且呢，这是在释迦丹尼玛哈布五百年以前在世的时候，非常的这个盛行的一种文化。
Of course, Lord Chaitanya did. It was actually allowed. It was arranged that Lord Chaitanya could meet the king.
当然了，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他其实是可以被安排或者被允许去见这位国王的。
Yes, this afternoon we'll describe about that how it was arranged.
但是今天下午的时候呢，我们会探讨如何安排了Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu与这位国王的相见。
The king has to disguise himself a little bit, and he has to become an ordinary person.
那这位国王呢？他必须要化妆，就是要这个乔装打扮一番，把自己给打扮成一个普通的人的样子。
So, Srila Prabhupada he was happy to meet important people, particularly state leaders and influential people.
那周爸爸他是很开心的去见到这些政要人物的，特别是比如像是这个州长啊，或者是一些很有影响力的人。
But they should be willing to hear. They should be interested in Krishna consciousness.
但是这些人呢，他必须要有兴趣去聆听，必须有兴趣去聆听关于Krishna知觉的信息。
Just like we have had the king of Puri, present day time, there's still a king of Puri. He doesn't have the position like what he had 500 years ago, but there's still a king of Puri, and he came here to Mayapur before, and sometimes he will, every year he goes to Rath Yatra.
但是呢，这位普瑞的国王呢，他依然还会每年都会去马尔普，而且呢，他还会参加弹车节。
One devotee was saying, he said, "You know, Prabhupada, I want to bring the Queen of England and the President of America. I want to bring them here to Mayapur. But maybe when we open the big temple, we can bring important people like the President of USA and the Queen of England. Bring them here to Mayapur."
然后有位奉献者就对舍尔帕帕说呢，说等我们的这个大庙建起来以后呢，我希望能够把英国的女王以及像美国的总统都能够请到马尔普来。
And Prabhupada said, if you do that, Bhaktivinoda Thakur will come and take you back to Godhead.
舍尔帕帕说，如果你要能做到这一点的话呢，那么 Bhaktivinoda Thakur 会亲自来把你带回到守身身边去的。
So, you know, there's some way in which you can utilize these important people in the service of Krishna.
那所以说呢，我们其实可以有一些方式能够利用这些非常重要的就重要级的这个人物，把它们用于对Krishna的服务之中。
But according to the strict principle, we don't meet with materialistic people. Materialistic people who are only interested in sense gratification.
但是呢，根据这严格的原则来说呢，我们不要去见那些只是对于感官享乐感兴趣的物质倾向的人。It's
not that we're against women, all women, but we're against materialistic women who are just only interested in sense gratification.
并不是说我们就是排斥所有的女子，而是排斥那些只是对感官享乐感兴趣的物质主义倾向的女子。And
similarly with kings and other such people like politicians, if they're only interested in sense gratification, then there's no point to meet them.
同样的，比如说像一些政客呀，或者一些这些人，如果他们要是只是对物质的感官享乐感兴趣的话，那我们也没有兴趣去和他们有任何的交道可打。We
have to know how to preach to these kind of people, how to engage them in Krishna consciousness.
那我们必须要知道如何向这样的人去传教，如何让他们也致力于对 Krishna 知觉的服务之中。
One time in USA, the devotees were walking and they walked past the house of a very rich man. And they told Prabhupada that this man is one of the richest men in the world. He has oil mines.
那有一次呢，当奉献者们在散步的时候呢，他们就经过了一个富豪的家，然后奉献者就对舒尔帕帕说呢，这是基本上就属于是美国的首富了，因为他有油田，他有油矿。
So, Prabhupada said, "Oh, you're going to preach to him. What will you preach?"
然后呢，舍尔帕帕说，如果你要是向他去传教的话，那你向他怎么传教呢？
So one devotee said, "We'll tell him surrender to Krishna." And Prabhupada said, "You think he'll be interested?"
然后奉献者就说呢，我们要告诉他要向 Krishna 皈依。
Another devotee said, Prabhupada will tell me it's not the body. Prabhupada said, you should tell him he's a big thief, that he's stolen all the oil from Krishna, and at the time of death, Krishna will punish him for all his stealing. So like that, Prabhupada had his vision on how to preach to these people and how to deal with these different people. Are there any other questions?
No, that is only question for now. 请问大家还有别的风, now here's another question from Krishna Balaram Prabhu. Divine Guru Maharaj, 渴望 Krishna 的爱是 Vaishnava 必须的品质和职责吗? Please accept my very humble obeisances. Hankering the love for Krishna, is that the must quality and duty for a Vaishnava?
Yes, that's the goal, that's the ultimate goal of Krishna consciousness.
是的, 这是Krishna知觉的最终的目标。
Right, the our scriptures cover three different topics.
那我们的经典呢,
there is Sambandha, knowledge of the relationship between God and the material world and the living entities.
那么第一个呢,
and then there is knowledge of Abhidaya. Abhidaya is about the process. How to apply that knowledge. We've got the knowledge about the relationship, how to apply that. That's the science of devotional service.
那然后呢是Abhidaya，Abhidaya的意思呢，就是我们现在已经有了这门知识，但是呢，我们如何，就是我们现在已经知道了，就是这个关系，这个知识，但是我们如何能够把这个知识给运用到我们的这个程序之中。
And then Prayojana is the third topic of the scriptures. Prayojana means the goal of devotional service. And the goal of devotional service is to develop love of God.
然后呢是Prayojana，Prayojana是我们经典的第三部分内容。那它讲的是我们的奉爱服务的目标。那奉爱的目标是什么呢？就是如何能够爱神。
We all have the propensity, we all have that ability to love, but we give our love to our car, we love our apartment, we love our wardrobe, we love our shoes, we love our handphone, we love money. You know, nobody has love of Krishna. So we really want to try to develop this attachment for Krishna. Krishna is a person, and he's the best friend we have, and we have a relationship with him.
那我们真正想做的事情呢，就是真正的去培养和Krishna之间的这种关系。那Krishna他是一个人，我们和Krishna之间本来就是一个关系的。
We should be thinking, when are we going to see Krishna? When are we going to get that chance to be with Krishna? We should be hankering for Krishna. Oh, Krishna, where are you? When are you going to come?
Oh, Krishna, 你在哪里呀? 你什么时候才能来呢?
So we have attachment for everything. We are attached to our, you know, everything else but Krishna. We have to try to develop this attachment for Krishna.
所以我们现在呢, 是除了对Krishna之外, 有很多的依附之情，但是我们要真正做的呢，是要培养去对 Krishna 的依恋。
So devotional service is not just only activities, but it's also an emotional experience.
所以呢，奉献礼物它并不仅仅是一些活动，而且呢是情感上的体验。
We want to actually develop this emotional attachment for Krishna, that how much Krishna cares about us, that he sends pure devotees here to teach us and to guide us.
那所以我们是希望培养出在情感上对 Krishna 的这种依恋。那我们可以看到 Krishna 他其实是多么好的在照顾着我们，他把他的这个奉献者派到我们的面前来教导我们，来指导我们。
He comes in the deity forms just to attract us.
那 Krishna 他以神像的形象显现，为的就是要吸引我们。
He comes to speak the Bhagavad Gita, and he came as 500 years ago as Lord Chaitanya to chant the holy name.
那 Krishna 他前来讲述了国家放歌。并且在五百年以前呢，以 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的形象显现，并且高唱着圣名。
We have to become really mad for Krishna.
所以呢，我们确实要让自己真的为 Krishna 而疯狂。
So, this is the goal of life. Lord Chaitanya said, "Prem Punarto Mohan." Prem.Punarto Mohan, the goal of life is to develop love of God.
So, this is our life's goal. That Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, "Pre-Pramato Mohan," the meaning is, our
Now, if we ask people, "What is your goal of life?" Someone will say, "Oh, I want to be rich."
那当我们在问人们你的这个生命的目标是什么呀？那有些人就会说啊，我想让自己变得富有。
Somebody else will say, "Oh, I want to get married to a rich man and have 10 children."
那有些人说呢，哦，我想嫁给一个有钱人，然后生十个孩子。
And somebody else will say, "I want to be famous as an actress or an actor."
那有些人说呢，我想让自己变得出名，我想成为一个名演员。
Everybody has their own different goals, what they want to do. It's all so limited and so foolish.
那么，所以每一个人呢，其实都对自己想做的事情有一个目标，但是呢，是很有限的，而且也是很蠢的。
But the real goal of life is to develop love for Krishna.
因为我们生命真正的目标是培养出对 Krishna 的爱。
So how to do that? We have to become greedy to get that love for Krishna.
但是怎么能够得到呢？我们必须要变得我们必须要让自己变得非常的贪婪的，想要得到对 Krishna 的爱。
We have to have a very strong desire that I want this very badly.
而且呢，我们要培养出非常强烈的愿望，我特别特别的想要。
Just like in China, sometimes you know some students they want to get a scholarship to go to America and study, and in order to prepare for the examination, you know, what is it, GRS or some exam, TOEFL or something, they have to take some exam to test their English. They will memorize every word in the dictionary, and they know every word in the dictionary and its meaning.
那有的时候在中国呢，就一些学生希望能够得到美国大学的奖学金，然后呢，能够到国外去留学。那但是他要得到这个奖学金呢，他必须要参加这个托福考试或者是GRS 的这个考试。那他为了要考过呢，他就必须要背字典中的每一个英文单词的意思。
So you know they have a really strong desire. They spend so much time, so much energy to do all that, to memorize all that.
因为他的这个愿望是非常强烈的，所以呢，他就要花很多的时间，花很多的精力去准备这个考试，然后呢，去背所有的这些单词。
So we should want to go to Krishna. We should want to develop love for Krishna. We have to have a desire. We have to really want.
所以如果我们要是想要去到 Krishna 那里，想要培养出对 Krishna 的爱的话呢，我们就必须要有这种强烈的愿望，必须要有这种强烈的渴望。
So. This is Krishna consciousness.
所以这就是 Krishna 知觉。
Prabhupada would often quote the verse, there's a verse from the scriptures, Krishna bhakti ratha bhava tamati kriyadam yadoti labhyate tatra loyam api muyam ekalam janma koti sukriterna labhyate. The verse says, it talks about you have to have the intense desire, this loyam, the very strong desire, very strong greed to get Krishna consciousness.
是的，爸爸经常会引出这个师姐，这师姐就是说呢，你必须呢要有这种 longing， 就这种贪恋，这种非常强烈的渴求，来得到 Krishna 的爱。
And it's a muyam ekalam. Only there's only one price. You cannot bargain. You cannot get a discount.
而且呢，就只有一，就是得到这个只有一个价格，这个价呢是不能够讨价还价的。
You know, when you go to the night market, we will always argue the price.
比如说，当我们到夜市去买东西的时候，我们老在那儿讨价还价。
You go in the big store, you cannot argue the price. But you go to the night market, you can argue.
如果我们要是去大商场买东西的话呢，我们是不能讨价还价的。可是要去夜市的话呢，就老能讨价还价。
So Krishna conscious, you want Krishna consciousness, you want to get love of Krishna, you have to pay the price.
所以如果我们要是想得到 Krishna 知觉，想要爱 Krishna 的话，我们就必须要付这个价格。
You have to want it really badly.
真的，我们必须要非常非常的渴望的想要得到它才可以。
Okay, is there any other question?
啊，谢了，国内那个微信这边有一个问题，是福州的苏尼提马太吉。非常想问请教一下咕噜顶拜咕噜马哈拉吉，他说他在博家梵歌的第十五章第195页的第一段说，这奉爱瑜伽修行能助人远离一切恐惧和愤怒，并因此让人在这一 超然的境界中感受到超灵的存在，请问咕噜如何能感受到超灵的存在呢？顶拜咕噜的莲花组。
就是 Krishna 知觉能够让人感受到超灵的存在，是吧？
他说，这个博伽梵歌这一段说，这个奉爱瑜伽修行的人能够帮助人远离超灵。
Okay, Suniti Maharaj's question. She said that in the Bhagavad Gita chapter 15, there was a purport from Srila Prabhupada.So that for the practitioners for Bhakti Yoga, they actually can stay away from all the fears, and they actually can, and they also can feel the presence of the Super Soul. So her question is that how can really feel the presence of Super Soul?
Well, we can feel the presence of the Super Soul by chanting the Hare Krishna mantra.
那我们可以通过唱诵 Hare Krishna 的曼陀罗来感受到超灵的存在。
You will feel the Krishna in your heart. You will feel how the Super Soul reacts with the chanting of the holy name.
那么这会儿呢，当你在唱诵圣名的时候呢，你就可以在心中感受到 Krishna 的存在，而且呢，你也能够感受到 Krishna 他是如何在进行反应的。
We also feel the presence of the Super Soul from the heart because we feel often.Krishna instructing us sometimes, giving us guidance, guiding us, giving us knowledge.
这有的时候呢，我们也经常会感受到 Krishna 他会在给我们指导，通过把知识传递给我们，以这样的方式，我们能够感受到超灵的存在。
Krishna says, knowledge, remembrance, and forgetfulness, they all come from the Super Soul.
Krishna 他说呢，记忆、知识和遗忘都是来自于超灵的。
So we can feel how the Super Soul arranges these things for us according to our desire.
那么所以呢，我们可以看到是根据我们的愿望，超灵它在为我们安排着所有的一切。
We feel the presence of the Super Soul as the overseer and the permitter.
而且呢，我们也可以看到，超灵呢，它是以一个监督者和允许者的这个身份在存在着。
We're thinking what to do, and we hear Krishna telling us from the heart, oh, this is not a good thing, no, you shouldn't do this, this is not proper, this is against the religious principles, don't do this. So Krishna speaks to us in the form of, from the heart, as the super soul.
那所以呢, Krishna 他是作为超灵, 在我们的内心中和我们在讲话。
Are you willing to hear?
但是你愿不愿意去听呢?
Often we don't want to hear, we just pretend we don't hear.
但经常的我们其实就不想听,所以我们就假装我们没听见。
But Krishna is there and he's speaking to us, he's guiding us.
但是 Krishna 其实就在那儿，他在跟我们讲话，他在指导着我们。
So we can feel Krishna like that.
那所以呢，我们就可以这样的方式去感受到 Krishna 的存在。
All right, Hare Krishna.
Maharaj, here's one more question here from 美玲八大姐，顶拜佛的莲花族，请问怎样能够培养希望得到 Krishna 强烈的爱的渴望？ Maharaj, please accept my very humble obeisances to your lotus feet. My question is that how to develop the desire of to get the strong desire of loving Lord Krishna?
Well, you have to become fascinated by Krishna.
首先呢，你必须呢要被Krishna，你要为Krishna而感到激动。
You have to become very much attached to him, to seeing his form and to hearing his about his activities and to chanting his name.
那你呢，要变得对Krishna非常的依附，比如说呢，要很依附的去看他的形象，很依附的去唱诵他的圣名，去聆听他的活动。
If we take up these activities of bhakti yoga with enthusiasm and with dedication, then we will become more attached to Krishna.
那如果我们要是非常热情的，并且呢，也满怀着奉爱之情的去从事在Bhakti Yoga中的这些活动的话，那我们就会变得对Krishna越来越依附。
Reading the books about Krishna and chanting the holy name with the devotees, visiting the holy places, it all helps us to develop attachment for Krishna. Sometimes people feel that, oh, I don't remember anything, I do all these things, but I don't remember anything. So there's a story that one man was saying, he said, my wife has been cooking for me for 30 years, and you know, I don't remember everything, I don't remember anything she cooks, but every day she cooks for me and I eat her cooking. And he said, I don't remember anything, what she cooks or the ingredients or anything, but I get nourished by eating the meals.
但是呢，因为我也不知道他给我都做了些什么佐料，他是怎么做的。但是呢，我就知道我吃了他给我做的饭，我就得到了滋养。So
the same way we may be hearing, we may not remember anything, but we get a lot of nourishment simply by taking part in these activities.
那么同样呢，我们也许可能在聆听，可是呢，我们都记不住我们所聆听的内容，但是就是由于我们从事了聆听的这个活动，使得我们得到了很多的滋养。
Okay, so thank
yes,
you.
Yes, Maharaj, Meilin has one more question here. She's asking, 请问 Gurudev, 怎么知道是超灵和我们说话，而不是自己的心意在说话呢? Guru Maharaj, how do we know that it's actually it's a super soul is talking to us, but not the my it's not my own mind to talk to me?
Well, you have to check that with the Vaishnavas, with the spiritual teachers and the senior devotees. They can guide you.
那么这个呢，你就必须要和灵性导师，还有 Vaishnava， 就是还有年长的奉献者去进行求证，因为他们可以指导我们。
Yeah, we have three authorities: Sadhu, Shastra, and Guru. So you can check.
我们有三个。那我们有三个权威，Sadhu 经典和 Guru。那我们可以通过他们来进行求证。
So, yeah, you have to guard against the mind. Make sure it's not you're not just bewildering yourself with some nonsense speculation from the mind. So check with Sadhu, Shastra, and Guru.
那所以说呢，就必须要有要必须要这样的防卫。那么不要让自己的这个心智推销的这个心意来迷惑了自己。所以呢，就要通过用沙度经典和咕噜来进行求证。
Okay.
Yeah, one more question, sir. From Brother Priyama 的顶拜咕噜的莲花族，在内心看到超灵是达到 Krishna Prema 必须经历的过程吗？Is that you know?Seeing the super soul in the heart, is that the master process to go through to reach to Krishna Prema? Getting Krishna Prema, is that necessary to actually see the super soul in the heart?
Well, certainly, Paramatma realization will be included in Bhagavan realization.
那么这个 Paramatma 的觉悟，超灵的觉悟，它是包含在八万的觉悟之中的。
Just like one who has $100, he also has $50, he also has $10. It's all there within the $100. So one who has Bhagavan realization, he also has Paramatma realization and Brahman realization.
那么就好像有一个人，他有$100，也就意味着他这$100里面包含了他所拥有的$50和$10。那所以呢，同样道理，就是当一个人他具有八个万的觉悟的时候，那也就意味着他的 Paramatma 的觉悟和他的 Brahman 的觉悟已经包含其中了。
So one cannot have love of God and no Paramatma realization.
所以呢，一个人他不可能得到了神爱，但是呢，没有 Paramatma 超灵的觉悟。
That's not possible.
这是不可能的。
Okay.
Maharaj, so this is everything, yes.
What? That's everything now?
Yeah, everything now, from what I can see here.
All right. So we thank Tanakeli Mataji for giving us so many days of her wonderful service and translation.
My great honor. Thank you very much, Maharaj.
Oh, please. You're too humble. Oh, and thank all the devotees for listening and questions and everything. And we'll be back in the afternoon.
非常感谢所有的奉献者的聆听，还有大家所提出的这么好的问题。然后我们下午再接着聆听。
Okay, Srila Prabhupada ki. Go back to Vrinda. Go back to Vrinda ki. Hare Krishna. Ding bai ni mandir lingwa ju. Ding bai ni mandir lingwa ju. Hare Krishna.
你们要是我的顶拜啊，你们要露面顶拜。
Hare Krishna.